Good evening. Welcome again to another episode of An Uncomfortable Truth, the show that dives deep into things that we really should know, but for some reason don't. And today, I'm coming to one of the most uncomfortable of uncomfortable truths that we're going to talk about, and that is life is a business. I don't care what you've seen, I don't care what you've heard, life is a business. Everything that you've held true up to this point goes back to life being a business. And there are three core components of this business that you need to be aware of. All aspects of life are transactional. That's the first one. Second one, businesses deal in transactions. And the third is simply you give and you get. We're going to dive into all of those points and see if we can come to some sort of consensus at the end of it. And once again, you don't have to necessarily believe what I'm saying. It's a free country. Do what you want. And I'm not out here trying to sway you or change your mind or make you to think anything. I'm simply offering you another point of view. And afterwards, I'm hoping that you would let it melanate in your head a little bit, let it marinate, come to your own conclusions, and act on those conclusions. That's all we can ask. And once again, we operate in the rule of three. Like, subscribe, notification. Three separate actions, 3 seconds, help the algorithm for YouTube to grow the channel and give us even bigger and better things, because there are a lot of very important things, a lot of fun things coming in the pikes, but it needs money and we don't have it like that. So anything you can do to help will be most appreciated. And now, with that being said, on to the program. First rule of an uncomfortable truth in life as a business is all aspects of life are transactional. Every period, single period, one period. You can't do anything in this life without it being looked at as a transaction. And also, it ties into the third rule, because transactions are simply you give something and you get something. Transaction. I give to you, you give to me. That's it in a nutshell. It isn't some huge to-do, it's not a big conspiracy, there's nothing like that. I give to you, you give to me. End of story. Now, I said before that all actions, aspects of life are transactional. And this goes without saying, each and every one is transactional, because each and every one of your transactions, you give and you get. For example, the simple act of breathing is transactional. You breathe in, you get. You breathe out, you give. Simple as that. Breathing. Breathe in, you're getting. Breathe out, you're receiving. Probably get that wrong, but you know what I'm talking about. Another instance of transactions. There are other transactions you do every day, like getting on the bus, buying gas, buying groceries, that sort of thing, where you give me the product I give you my money. Give and get. That's what it is. I want a car. I signed the paperwork for you to release the car to me. I'm giving consent. I'm allowing this transaction to happen. In return, I get the car. I get the groceries. I ride the bus. And these type of transactions, these transactions happen on a day-to-day basis. And most times it happens without you even thinking about it. Because you've been conditioned to think about it. You've been conditioned to know that this is how it is. You give me, I give you. That's pretty much it. And there isn't much you can say or do to make people think otherwise, because that's just plain silly. Our second aspect of it is businesses deal in transactions. And this also goes without saying. Because businesses are the heart of any transaction, because the business is the facilitator. It is the middleman between you and what you want or what you need. I need a car. So I need to go to a car dealership to fill out the paperwork to obtain a car. I'm hungry. So I need to go to a supermarket to pay for the items I want to get so I can go home and have food. I need to get somewhere. I don't have any way to get there. So I need to pay my fare to a bus, and it will take me where I need to go. Now, each of these instances have nuances that make them a little bit different than the others. But generally, all in all, it's all the same thing. You give me, I give you. Simple transaction. Or better yet, for you computer nerds out there, they're the classic if-then statement. If I give you, then you give me. Simple transaction. And that dovetails very neatly into you give and you get. And I've given you examples of what you give and what you get in return. And everything that we've discussed up to this point is indeed a transaction. So this little bit of information, these uncomfortable truths, dovetail very nicely into the overarching dating platform. Most people think of dating as, in terms of a relationship, as we're going out together, we love each other, blah, 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 blah. Which is true. However, looking at it from the business point of view, it's a transaction. You give me your heart, I give you mine. Or, and more to the point, you give me fit, feminine, and friendly, and I give you access to my time, my resources, and my energy. And everything that happens in that relationship can tie directly back to a transaction. You can cheat for whatever reason, right or wrong. Actually, cheating in and of itself is wrong. Let's start with that. That being said, the reason for cheating can be attributed to a few things. One, the guy has looked out for something that he's not getting from at home. Two, the girl is looking for something that she's not getting at home. Those are the two main ones we're going to deal with. There's a song by Sherelle and Alexander O'Neill, entitled Everything I Miss at Home. And in this song, they talk about you give me attention, you understand my needs. You give me everything I miss at home. This means that during the course of interactions, there are components that are no longer in place. They were there in the beginning, otherwise they wouldn't be together. But if they no longer are there, a touch, a kiss, something as crude as a pat on the backside, compliment, those little things are no longer present. And this goes back to something that I've always said. You can give me the world and it doesn't mean anything. It's the little things that mean a lot to me. Just the little things. And the more I think about it, the more I know that's true. For example, in my lifetime, in my day, I am 26 years and counting of happy marriage. Do we fight? Yes. We argue. We have disagreements. But it all comes back down to the point where we can get past those because of how we feel about each other. I don't say I love you as much as I should, as much as I believe I should. That's something I'm working on. That's something that can change. But going back to the transactional thing is one Christmas. Matter of fact, the Christmas before we came home back to the States, I had an Xbox. That Xbox broke. I'm like, oh well, it broke. My wife, for Christmas, bought me an Xbox 360. She didn't have to do that. I didn't even ask for it. But she thought enough of me and my contentment and my happiness to get that for me. And I'm like, wow. She got to me. And the more I thought about it, and the more I think about it, the more I realized that this one's a keeper. This one, I'm going to hold on to for dear life, come hell or high water. The little things. Going back even further, when we were dating, I was working at a Radio Shack. And I was, and still am, a big Knicks fan. And my favorite player at the time was Patrick Ewing, number 33. One of the Twin Towers. Him and Hakeem Olajuwon. I still think if they could have got the two of them together, that would have been an unstoppable team. But it is what it is. Anyway, one day, after work, I went and got her. And she says, I got a present for you. I'm like, what? She's like, close your eyes. Close my eyes. Open them. Open my eyes. It's a picture. Patrick Ewing going up for a dunk. I had that picture from that moment to when we moved to England. And I probably still have it now. I just need to look a little bit harder through the things we have. But that's how much that meant to me. And I didn't ask for that either. Another thing that she told me, and she said it time and time again, and I've gotten better, but I think I still have a bit further to go, is I don't care what you get me. I just want you to think about it. And I'm always like, no, I want to know because I want to get you what you want so that you can be happy. But as time went on, it began to dawn on me what she meant. And what she meant was it's the thought that counts. Not so much what you get, the thought behind it. I got this for you because I thought X, Y, Z. I saw this and thought of you. Therefore, I got it. And that goes back to the transaction. You gave me a part of you. You gave me something that I wanted, or in some cases, didn't even know that I wanted. So in return, I give you all of me. I give my time, my resources, my energy. Looking at it from that basic standpoint, life is very simple. And that's what it comes down to. Everybody makes out your life is difficult, it's challenging, this everything. No, it's not. Life is as simple or as difficult as we make it. And this is one of the ways I'm telling you, you can make it easier for yourself. Men tend to operate on a risk assessment level. Risk versus reward. Will the rewards be at least equal, if not greater, than the risks involved? If I marry her, will I be happy down the road and not have to worry about things like infidelity or divorce or things of that nature? Women, conversely, think on the emotional aspect. If I give myself to him, will I always be happy? Will I never have to worry about things like infidelity and promiscuity, all this other stuff? Newsflash. The answer is no. Because things are fluid. Things change on a day-to-day basis, minute to minute. Newsflash number two. Happiness is always in flux. It's a state of being. It's not etched in stone. It's not permanent. It fluctuates. It's in flux. It's in emotion. And because it's in emotion, it is to be treated as such. You're not going to be happy with your partner every day for the rest of your days. There are going to be days where you can love her to death, but you can't stand her. And that's okay. That's a part of life. There will be days when you love that person deliriously. And other days, you don't even want to look at her. Or him. That's fine. You're doing it right. My rule of thumb in relationships, dating, and marriage has always been at the end of days, when everything is said and done, I want to make sure that I have more good days than bad days. I want to make sure that when my partner, my wife, lays her head down to sleep, she'll have more good thoughts than bad thoughts. That's it. That's it in a nutshell. That's all you can hope for. And that's all I hope for. I hope that the ups outnumber the downs, the good days outweigh the bad days, and I smile more than I frown. If you can do that consistently, you're on your way to the best of all possible outcomes. Because in all honesty, it's not happiness that's the key. It's contentment. Because contentment breeds happiness. Remember, happiness is an emotion. Happy is an emotion. Contentment is a state of being. When you're content, you're at peace. You're at peace with yourself, you're at peace with your environment, you're at peace with others around you. And when you're at peace, you tend to be happy. See that? You tend to be happy. And in the end of it, that's all that matters. And with that, we're going to wrap up the show. You come to get the end of another. Let's just say, this is one of the more interesting topics I've had. Because life is a business. Life is based on transactions, and transactions are perceptions. And perception is key. Something to think about. Needless to say, as always, we operate the rule of three. Like. Subscribe. Notify. Notification. Each act takes 1 second. Each act is free. Never cost you anything. And yet, if enough of you do those three things, take the 3 seconds out of your day, you watch the video, take the next logical step. YouTube algorithm will see that and say, hey, this is interesting. I'm going to pass this out to more people. And that's what we mean by organic growing. Because it happens naturally. You don't pay for it. You don't trade for it. It's free. You like it. You subscribe it. YouTube algorithm disperses it to more people. More people like it. And it grows organically that way. And the growth is exponential. Each like, each subscribe, each notification helps us grow, and hopefully, as we grow, more things will come of it, and you like what you see coming down the road. I think you will. And the best way to see it and be one of the first to see it is to do those three things. You want to rock with it? Take it a bit further. In this comment section, pinned to the comment section will be ways you can donate. Donations go even further because donations help us upgrade the equipment and stuff that we have that we've used to make these shows. More equipment. Better resources, more content, more likes, more donations. It's cyclical, it's cyclical. Like it. And at the end of it, we hope that we brought a little sunshine into your day. And until the next, this is OBJ, your commander-in-chief, highly favored, humble host, saying, Thank you for coming. Thank you for watching. Peace to you. Here we are. Like a polished.